I am risen, and I am always with you. Alleluia. You have placed your hand upon me. Alleluia. Your wisdom has been shown to be most wonderful. Alleluia. Alleluia. Today we celebrate Easter Sunday of the Resurrection of the Lord. The parish bulletin found at the entrances and on our webpage contains the music and readings from Mass. Today's Mass intention is for the people of the Cathedral Parish. The celebrant of this Mass is Father Ubel, and assisting at this Mass is Deacon Phil Stewart. The opening hymn may be found at number 451, The Strife is O'er, number 451, Let Us Stand.
Third morning, we rose again. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Kyrie eleison.
Let us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlock for us the path to eternity. Grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee, after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice, let us rejoice. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice, let us rejoice. Let us rejoice and
thank you. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
O
On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdalene came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. And so she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciples whom Jesus loved, and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there and the cloth that had covered his head, but not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. And then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed, for they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My friends in Christ, I begin by extending to all of you my promise of prayers and best wishes on this beautiful Easter Sunday. What a privilege and joy to see so many of you here. And I also want, in case I forget at the end of Mass, to acknowledge that there are some in our midst who were here last night for a three-hour Easter vigil and yet came back to help again. I'm thinking in particular of our wonderful choir. We are so graced with their presence. They've been doing a lot of work these past days. And also some of our altar servers were here last night and returned to assist again at the 10 o'clock. And to all who worked to make this church so beautiful, we are deeply grateful. We put on our best because this is as good as it gets. Easter Sunday, the very core of our faith. About 6 or 7 years ago, I made a trek to Nepal with my older brother. Not so sure I could do it today, but all along that two-week trek to the base of Mount Everest, we were told again and again, you need to drink more water, otherwise you'll get sick. Please empty your bottles before lunch, and then we'll fill them and you do the same thing. This incessant mantra went on and on. And I was thinking to myself for a time, you know, we're not camels. I can't drink 50 gallons of water in a single sitting. But they did it to protect our health. Though not thirsty, I drank. I was in a very foreign country. I didn't know what to expect. I trusted. My brothers and sisters, I quickly learned that purifying and lugging nearly 7 pounds of water is tiresome, yet also realized that my body needed to work harder in order to maintain a healthy blood oxygen level. There's simply not much oxygen at that high level, and dehydration sneaks up in a moment's notice. They're on guard for our physical health. However, when it comes to our spiritual lives, we are not as swift to recognize the warning signs of spiritual thirst. Sadly, we don't always have someone readily at hand to remind us. And too often we search for meaning and satisfaction, sometimes aimlessly so, in a world that is utterly incapable of providing the ultimate meaning for which we yearn. The solution may be right there in front of us, yet we miss it. The great thing about Easter is the liturgy is filled with all these incredible symbols It comes to a crescendo last night at the Easter Vigil with the candle, the oil, the wax, and of course the water. You blessed yourselves this morning with water blessed last night. After the homily, you'll go through the church again, sprinkling you with water blessed by the Archbishop last night. We take to heart the words of the angel to the women at the tomb. Do not be afraid. He is not here, for he has been raised just as he said. And we affirm today with all of our hearts that Jesus Christ has indeed risen. He's rewarded our spiritual thirst with the life-giving water of salvation. And the hallowed silence of the tomb has given way to Easter morning. Our Lord and Savior has risen from the depths of human pain and suffering. He's entered into our brokenness so that you and I might be healed. And so the Easter liturgy principally highlights three symbols: light, water, and the long-awaited proclamation of the Easter Alleluia. Christ is the light of the world, he who transforms chaos into cosmos. At times, we only see the darkness of a world seemingly no longer in need of a Savior. And we know how wrong that is, how mistaken. We've all watched in sorrow what's transpired in the Holy Land since last October. Now, Easter is not a day to dissect a very complicated political and religious situation that dates back centuries. Yet even the horrors of war cannot obscure the ultimate triumph of good over evil, of friendship over hatred, of light over darkness. If you pay attention to these things, you might have realized we've been gaining 3 minutes and 9 seconds of daylight each year this month. It may not seem like a lot, but it means it's 90 minutes since the beginning of March. The light is winning. The darkness is losing. Our faithful Jewish brothers and sisters saw the Torah as the lamp for our steps and the light for our path, separating light from darkness within creation. In the book of Proverbs, the young were encouraged to keep the teaching of the law fastened over their hearts. For the bidding is a lamp, the teaching is a light. And so the symbolism of the Easter Alleluia, deliberately sung 3 times in a row at the vigil, expresses in words the inner transformation that we all experience. The transformation in joy. The very first reference in Scripture to singing is the account from Exodus describing the crossing of the Red Sea. So grateful for their liberation from slavery, the people all began to sing out in song. I will sing to the Lord, for he is gloriously triumphant. Horse and chariot he has cast into the sea. Not even the recent 12-inch snowstorm will dampen our spirits, for we know that spring indeed is on the way. We've arrived at the dawn of a new life in Easter, and you have all decided to be with us this morning to rejoice together, and I'm truly grateful for your presence at the cathedral. The beautiful flowers you see in the sanctuary remind us what's around the corner. In our own backyards, soon enough, neither the wars, political or cultural divisions, nor any other societal problems or family problems or challenges, they don't disappear, but they are able to be seen in a new light this morning, a new and more brilliant light. We offer profound thanks to our Lord for his act of humble sacrifice on Good Friday. The best way, it seems to me, that we can return our thanks is by lives of joyful service, and to do so in his name. Be a person who recognizes the light the dual task and privilege to carry forth the message of hope and peace into the darkest corners of our world now falls to you and to me, that the light of truth and love may illumine all in its wake. So let's delay no longer. There's too much at stake. He has been raised. He is not here. Let us go forth to proclaim the good news. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so now I ask all of you, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty show?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness for our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
of Easter fills the whole universe. Certain of Christ's victory, let us present to the Father the needs of the Church and of the world.
For Pope Francis, Archbishop Hepta, Bishop Williams, and Bishop Eisen, may the resurrection of Christ give them renewed strength to proclaim the gospel with confidence and joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the newly baptized and confirmed this Easter, supported by our prayers, may they proclaim joyfully to the world the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations, of all exercise authority, may the risen Christ bless, guide, and protect them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those whom God is calling to the priesthood, the diaconate, or consecrated life, may they hear the Lord's call and respond with generosity and courage. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all Christians in war-torn countries, may they hold fast to their faith and trust in the risen Lord and rejoice in his presence in their lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for our brothers and sisters who have gone before us in faith, may they join the eternal banquet in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, giver of the gift of new life, please hear and answer these our humble prayers, for they are made in the strong and holy name of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. The Cathedral Parish is dependent upon the financial support of her cherished parishioners and many welcome guests. There is a QR code in the parish bulletin from which to donate electronically. You may also use any of the four gold-colored offering drop boxes found at the Selby and Dayton doors just inside the church for your stewardship. We thank you for your generosity.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Exalt him with paschal gladness, O Lord. We offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant your peace, to guard, unite, and govern throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Bernard, our Bishop, his assisting bishops, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or the offer for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you, also for those to whom you've been pleased to give the new birth of water and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness of all their sins. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection of the dead, and the glorious ascension to heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offered your glorious majesty from the gift that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel, the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who've gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Just a brief word about the distribution of Holy Communion. Since I know we have many visitors here today, we're delighted you're all here. Holy Communion is distributed section by section, so please wait until a communion minister arrives at your section. For those of you of the Catholic faith who are disposed and prepared to receive communion today, please enter into the aisle closest to the center from whichever section you are in, and then return by way of the opposite aisle. For those who may not be of our faith or who may not be receiving communion, please know you're very welcome to come forward for a blessing. Simply cross your arms in this manner, indicating your desire to receive a blessing. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. And also, for those who do require a low-gluten host, please come to the center aisle. I have the picks.
An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a few brief announcements this morning, so thank you so much for your attention. Again, we offer a special word of welcome to all who may be visiting, especially any out-of-town visitors. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. We're honored by your presence. Wonderful to see so many of you here today, also last night, and even this morning at 8 a.m., a very full church. We are deeply grateful to our many volunteers who prepared the church and the sanctuary and the side chapels. Be sure to check out the side chapels. Feel free to come and visit the Shrines of the Nations, as well as our BVM Chapel, St. Joseph Chapel, in the back. Our musicians, our sacristans, our cathedral staff have all worked overtime to prepare these sacred days, and I will just tell you on a personal note, I can't imagine a better Holy Week for my final Holy Week here in your service of the cathedral. It was just spectacular the whole way through, so thank you to all of our volunteers. Please note that next Sunday, our Divine Mercy program begins at 2 o'clock. It includes readings, confessions, Eucharistic adoration. It concludes with the Chaplet of Divine Mercy at 3 o'clock. Please note that one may attend confession at any time this coming week to receive the special graces for Divine Mercy Sunday. Confessions are offered here each day from 3:45 until 5 o'clock. Again, we thank you for your participation and continued strong support of the Cathedral. I do encourage you to take a bulletin home to learn more about the Cathedral, including registration information if you'd like to join our parish. And in a special final word, please keep in mind our 6 newly baptized and 12 newly received and confirmed members of our RCIA class. And I thank so much all those who sponsored them and journeyed with them to last night. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and adoption, give you gladness by his blessing.
Amen.
May he, by whose redeeming work you've received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And may you, who've already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
And the blessed blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, come down on you, remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Let us sing number 442. Jesus Christ is risen today, number 442.
Alleluia.